हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर मिस अदिति अनिल कुशारे, मास्टर ऑफ फार्मसी इन क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस टेक्निक्स फ्रॉम के वाघ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मसी चांदोरी नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सस्पेंशन फ्रॉम फार्मास्यूटिक्स टू क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सस्पेंशन। द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड आर एज फॉलोज: Introduction to suspension as a biphasic liquid dosage form and classification of suspension. Suspensions are the biphasic liquid dosage form of medicaments in which the finely divided solid particles, the range of solid particles in a suspension from 0.5 to 5 micron. Suspensions are used in orally, parenterally and also externally. They are chemically stable than solution. Classification of suspension based on general class, in that oral suspension, for an example paracetamol suspension, then second one externally applied suspension, in that example is calamine lotion, and parenteral suspension, example is insulin zinc suspension. Then second class of suspension, which is based on proportion of solid particles, dilute suspension 2 to 10% wet by volume solid, for an example cortisone acetate, prednisolone acetate, and concentrated suspension which contain 50% wet by volume solid, for an example zinc oxide suspension. Then based on electrokinetic nature of solid particle, that are flocculated suspension and deflocculated suspension. In that flocculated system or suspension, in flocculated system the individual particle are contact with each other to form loose aggregate and create network like structure. Rate of sedimentation is high. Sediment is loosely packed. When shaking, it can be redispersed easily and reform the original suspension. The flocculated suspensions not be elegant because they are difficult to remove from bottles or vials, and on transferring from the bottle, the flocules remaining sticking to the side of the bottle. Then deflocculated or non-flocculated system. In deflocculated system, the individual particle are exist as a separate entities. Rate of sedimentation is also low. Sediment is tightly packed. When shaking, it cannot be redispersed easily and form the cake. Deflocculated suspensions be elegant. They have pleasing appearance because the substance remains suspended for sufficient long time. So let's see the difference between flocculated and deflocculated suspension. In case of flocculated, the particles forms loose aggregates and form a network like structure. In case of non-flocculated, particles exist as a separate entities. In case of flocculated, the rate of sedimentation is high. In case of non-flocculated, rate of sedimentation is slow. Then flocculated, sediment is rapidly formed. In case of non-flocculated, sediment is slowly formed. Flocculated, in that sediment is loosely packed and doesn't form a hard cake. In case of non-flocculated system, sediment is very closely packed and a hard cake is formed. In case of flocculated, sediment is easy to redisperse. In case of non-flocculated, sediment is difficult to redisperse. In case of flocculated, suspension is not pleasing in appearance. In case of non-flocculated, suspension is pleasing in appearance. In case of flocculated, the flocules stick to the sides of the bottle. In case of non-flocculated, they don't stick to the sides of the bottle. So these are the with diagram explaining the deflocculated and flocculated suspension. So deflocculated suspension, it looks like this, and flocculated, flocules are formed like this, and this flocculated system, it look like this. So last class, that is based on size of particle, coarse suspension. Suspension having particle sizes of greater than about 1 micron in diameter are called as coarse suspension. Colloidal suspension, in that the suspensions having particle sizes of suspended solid less than about 1 micron in size are called as colloidal suspensions. So what we learned from this topic, classification of suspension, the learning outcomes are: what is suspension as a biphasic liquid dosage form, and a brief overview to the classification of suspension. Thank you.